Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. So let's begin. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. Amma ba'ad, fa'a'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Today we are going to cover Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 62 and onwards. Let's look at the ayah. Innal ladhina amanu wal ladhina hadu wan nasara was sabi'een. Indeed, those who have believed and those who were Jews or Christians or Sabians, those among them who believed in Allah and the last day and did righteous deeds, will have their reward with their Lord, and no fear will there be concerning them, nor will they grieve. So let's try to understand this ayah. Here we are learning about four different categories of people. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Who are these believers? The believers who believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then we learn about hadu, the ones who were Jews, the Jewish people, and they were the followers of Musa alayhi salam. And then we learn about Nasara. Who were an-Nasara? Nasara were the followers of Isa alayhi salam. And the last but not the least, the Sabians, was-Sabi'een. Who were they? They were the ones with no religion. So this is how we understand these four categories. So what do we learn about these four categories of people from this ayah? Man amana billahi wal yawmil akhir. So whoever believes in Allah and the last day, wa amila salihan, and after believing they don't stop, they do good deeds, then what happens? Falahum ajruhum, they will have reward. And what else? Wala khawfun alayhim wala hum yahzanun, they will have no fear and no grief. And subhanallah, when we look at the word khawf, it is referring to fear of the future. And when we look at the word huzn, it is referring to the grief of the past. When we have the correct belief and we start doing good deeds, we can have a very beautiful life, free from fear and free from grief. May Allah enable us to live a life like this here and also in Akhirah. Ameen. Let's move on to the next ayah. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 63, is about another incident to do with Bani Israel. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورِ. So we are learning about an incident to do with Bani Israel here. And recall when we took your covenant, O Bani Israel, to abide by the Torah. And we raised over you the mount. Which mount? Mount Tur. Saying, take what we have given you with determination. And remember what is in that, perhaps you may become righteous. So from this ayah we learn that this happened, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala literally raised up Mount Tur and suspended it in the air on top of the Bani Israel so that they take the book seriously, so they take Torah seriously. So let's try to guess what is the lesson for us in this verse. I am a book in elegant prints, to know my name, here are some hints. Rich in cover and nicely bound, in hearts of Muslims I'm rarely found. High on a shelf I'm usually kept, forgotten and neglected I am left. With respect I do get lots of kiss, my main point is what they always miss. At times I'm used for phony swear, my true use though is very rare. A miracle I am that can change the world, all one has to do is heed my word. I am your savior, I am your guide. So come and take heed, come and abide. I have wisdom, I have treasure, so much so there is no measure. Right from wrong is my fame, Holy Quran is my name. So from this poem, we also learn the behavior of Muslims with our book. So we need to, inshallah, mend our ways, and we need to take this lesson from this ayah that we need to take Quran seriously. So how are we going to take Quran seriously? How are we going to hold it with strength? By taking it with determination, by implementing its teachings, by following its commands, and by continuing to refer back to it for all our problems and to find the solutions in it for a better life and for an amazing afterlife. And when we implement Quran in our lives, then we have taqwa. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, as it comes in this ayah. So this is a beautiful connection, and this is a beautiful formula to get taqwa. When we hold on to the book, when we hold on to Quran, Allah guides us. When we get guidance, we do ibadah, we worship Allah. When we worship Allah, our taqwa increases. And this is a cycle. It's a beautiful cycle. And once we have taqwa, we care about the book even more. And when we care about the book even more, we get more guidance. When we get more guidance, we are able to perform better ibadah. And when we are able to perform better ibadah, when we're able to perform better worship, then Allah bestows us with mindfulness. And then we have taqwa. May Allah grant all of us taqwa. So in ayah number 63, we're learning about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the mount over Bani Israel, and they said, yes, yes, we are going to take the book seriously. We're going to take it with strength. But what happened? ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ مِن بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ Then you turned away after that. And if not for the favor of Allah upon you and His mercy, you would have been among the losers. So when we ignore the commands of Allah, when we don't take our covenants, our promises seriously, the promises we make with Allah, then we can become losers. May Allah save us from losing in this world and also in the next. Jazakumullahu khairan kaseera for paying attention. See you all next time with some more stories to do with Bani Israel and so many lessons to learn from them. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.